Okay, good morning all. So today we are going to discuss a very important chapter here. We can call it as like a revision, just like physics. Try to mute yourself, everyone. Physics is very, very important when it comes to UPSC examinations. Physics is very, very important when it comes to your UPSC examinations. Here you have to score high marks. Okay, just keep in mind. And it is very easy to score. So today we are going to see how the questions have been asked past 10 years, okay, and how the questions will be asked in future also, okay. And I have taught little basics of the chapters like light, okay. Then you have a basic chapter called as sound, okay. So light, sound, all the chapters are there. And just keep in mind, UPSC is behind your understanding of the subject, okay. Understanding of the subject. Anything you take, whether it is chemistry, biology, physics, they are going to check whether you have understand the subject or not. Okay, for example, law of buoyancy is there, then law of gravitation is there. Okay, then you have Newton's law of gravitation, that force is equal to m1 m2 divided by r square. Okay, so the questions will be asked on this, not a numerical kind of questions. Maybe one or two numerical questions they may ask you, but not all. Okay, not all. Now, numerical questions from where they are going to ask. Very, very important class today. Okay, try to focus on your numerical question. They will ask you to find the resistance in series, resistance in parallel. Okay, here this is a chapter called as electricity. Okay, there is a chapter called as electricity, and in this electricity chapter, you will have resistance in series, resistance in parallel, like that. You have a formula that is V is equal to IR. Then you have the resistance formula, that is RS. If the resistance in series, then the R1 plus R2 plus R3, it goes on till N number. Okay. Then you have resistance in parallel. That is equal to 1 by R1, 1 by R2. Okay, this way. So this is how the questions will be asked in your numerical kind of questions. Next, sometimes they ask, sometimes UPSC may ask you questions based on this. 1 by U plus 1 by V is equal to 1 by F. Okay. So what is meant by concave mirror? What is meant by convex mirror? Okay, like that. And in evening batch, I have dealt in detail. Okay, I have dealt in detail. What is meant by lens and what is meant by mirror, right? What is meant by lens and what is meant by mirror? Concave lens is there, convex lens is there. Concave mirror is there, convex mirror is there. So where is the application? Dentist, he use which kind of mirror? Whether he is using concave mirror, convex mirror, why? Okay, this kind of question they will ask you. Either they will ask you a simple question on application of the concave mirror or convex mirror, or they may give you a situation. Okay, they may give you a situation. So and so is a situation. Which kind of mirror or the lens will you prefer? Okay, this kind of question they are going to ask. Okay, fine. I hope that even the non-science background student, those who are from commerce background, there are a lot of people here who are joined from commerce background. Okay, they can easily give this question if you have studied till 10th standard science properly. Okay, till 10th standard science properly. So let us go and try to find the answers. The first question here, a beautiful rainbow in the sky is due to, this is a chapter, there is a chapter called as light. There is a chapter called as light, and in light we have seen different phenomena, something called as scattering of light. Okay, you have some scattering of light, then you have something called as reflection, then you have something called as diffraction, then you have something called as refraction. Okay, refraction. So these are all we have seen in the basic, like we have understood how the questions will be asked. Now we'll see the options. The rainbow in the sky is due to which of the following phenomenon? Dispersion of sunlight from water droplet only. With these words like only. Okay, next. Reflection of sunlight from water droplets only. Okay, water droplets only. Only reflection is taking place in the water droplet. That is the question. Next. Reflection and refraction of sunlight from the water droplet only. And the last, if you see, refraction, dispersion, reflection of sunlight from water droplet only. Very, very interesting and beautiful question. Can anyone tell me what the answer here?
DD. Sir, option D, refraction, dispersion, and reflection of sunlight from
water. Option D.
Okay, Arun Nayan is telling the answer. Ratan is telling the answer. Very good. What about Pranavi, Dineshwari? Tell me.
Option D, sir.
Okay, chalo. Fine, no problem. I'll explain. Those who are not getting the answer, I'll explain. Okay, don't interfere. Don't try to mute yourself. Very, very important chapter we are watching here. Now, suppose this is a rain droplet. Okay, and the sunlight is coming inside. So we have already seen a phenomenon, something called as refraction. Correct? In refraction, what happens when the light is traveling from lighter medium to denser medium? When the light is traveling from lighter medium to denser medium, it will bend towards normal. Correct? It will bend towards normal. Next, if the light is traveling from denser medium to lighter medium, those who have taken science in 11th and 12th, or those who are studying in 11th and 12th now in NDA, those who are preparing for NDA, for them this question is easy, but the questions for degree students, for you it will be a little confusing. If a light is traveling from denser medium to lighter medium, it will go away from normal. Understood? So this is what happens here. Now, here there is a medium called as air. Sunlight is coming here inside, and this is the water droplet. Imagine this is water here. So what happens? Lighter medium to denser medium, air, this light will bend and then it will go out like this. Okay, it is going to bend twice. In the same time, here some light will be reflected. Okay, some light will be reflected. So refraction is taking place 100%. Dispersion is nothing but when a white light is passing. Okay, inside white light, you have seven different colors. What are those colors?
Vibgyor.
Very good. Okay. Now, what these UPSC NDA guys or CDS guys are going to do? They will ask you a question, not in a simple way that how many lights are there, something like that. Okay. And we already know that, you know, violet will be scattered most, red will be scattered least. Okay. They will ask you why violet is scattering more and red is not scattering. Okay, they will ask you a question related to the speed of the violet light and speed of the red light, or the red color light. Understood? So here, we'll stick to this question. Now, the answer for this question is, okay, the answer for this question is, refraction is taking place at the same time in the water droplet. Dispersion is taking place in the same time in the water droplet. Reflection of the sunlight from water droplet. Okay, all this phenomenon takes place in this water droplet. How many of you understood? Do I need to explain again?
No.
Okay, next question. The weight of an object may be assigned using Newton's which law? Weight of an object, first motion, second law, third law, law of gravitation.
Law of gravitation.
Okay. People are telling law of gravitation. Option number D, they are telling, right? Okay. So before, see how to solve the question paper when you are practicing for your NDA examination, when you are practicing for your any competitive examination, what you should do in exam, they have given four options. Why they have given this four option? Is it related to question? You have to check it. Suppose if your mind is telling that, yeah, option is four. Okay. Now you should check what is option number A. Okay. Tell me Newton's first law of motion. What is that?
If you are
to MA,
inertia.
Yes. Can I call it as law of inertia? Or if I go with definition, any object continues to be in the state of rest or of uniform motion unless it is disturbed. Yes or no? How many of you remember?
Yes,
any object continues to be in the state of rest or of uniform motion unless it is disturbed. This is the law, first law of motion. Second law of motion is nothing but force is equal to ma, that is mass into acceleration. Okay, force is equal to mass into acceleration. I told you the questions here in UPSC, they will be logical kind of question. You need to understand each and every topic, only then you are able to answer the questions. Next, third law of motion is very easy, everyone can
equal and opposite.
Every action has equal and opposite reaction, correct? Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. This is called as Newton's third law of motion. Now I will show you the further slide. These are all previously asked NDA questions. Okay, these are all previously asked NDA physics question. What happens? Why I am discussing this question? Because the NDA questions are asked in CDS. CDS questions are asked in CAPF and vice versa. CDS questions are asked in NDA. Okay, everywhere the questions will be repeated. Okay, it is going to repeat one and different exams. Only thing is that if you are taking physics as a chapter, as a subject, you need to be thorough with all the basic things. If you are thorough with all the basic things, I bet you, you can easily crack this NDA, CDS and all. What is law of gravitation? Law of gravitation is equal to force into the product of the masses divided by the square of the distance between them, and I'm going to take the G constant. Okay, so this is the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Everyone understood? Okay, next.
Yes, sir.
Of 0.5 ampere is drawn by a filament of electric current for 20 minutes. For 20 minutes. Okay, it is a calculative question. The amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit is, okay, tell me how to do this. There is a formula for charge. What is that? Raghavan?
I is equal to Q by T, then Q is equal to I into T.
Yes, I is equal to Q by T. Very good. So charge I need to find. How much it is the charge? So I got the formula, that is Q is equal to IT. Yes or no? Q is equal to I into T. So what is the current giver here? Okay, now let me ask you a question. Sri Ratna, tell me what is the unit of current?
Ampere.
Ampere, yes. What is the unit of charge?
Volt.
Coulomb, no. That is the potential difference.
Volt.
Okay, so this is how it will be rotating. I told you in the beginning of the class now that questions, if they ask problematic question, they may ask you from the focus or that point of view, or they may ask you the questions from electric current, resistance in parallel, okay, find the volt, find, okay, something like this. Got it? So Raghavan is right in the answer, that is charge is equal to I into T. Tell me 0.5 into time is 20 minutes. So what is the answer?
600 coulomb, sir. C, sir.
So what is the option?
C.
C.
Sir, we need to convert 20 minutes into seconds, sir. Seconds, unit,
yeah,
of time.
So ampere per second. Charge is flow through per seconds. So 0.5 into 20 will be 10. Just a minute. 20 into 6, correct? So this will be like this. So answer is C here. Got it?
Sir,
rest of the guys, commerce guys, are you understanding?
Sir, I am not getting it, sir.
Who is not getting?
Karthik Raja.
Okay. See, listen here. Suppose if there is an electric wire. Okay. Suppose if there is an electric wire, and here I am going to pass an electric current. Okay, I'm going to pass an electric current. That current I'm calling it as I, and that is 0.5 ampere. Okay, that is 0.5 ampere. And I'm passing it for how many minutes? The time I'm passing it for 20 minutes. Okay, the time I'm passing it for 20 minutes. So in 1 minute, how many seconds are there? 60 seconds are there, correct? So for 20 minutes, what will it happen? So for 20 minutes, can I say this is 16 to 20 seconds? Correct? Now there is a formula, that is charge is equal to I into T. There is a formula that is charge is to I into T. This is 0.5 into, okay, 20 into 60. Now tell me, when you calculate this, how much answer you're getting? You will get 600 coulomb. Got it? This is how the questions will be asked. Karthik Raja, are you understanding? Basics, I will.
Yes, sir.
I'll do again, don't worry. This is like revision, okay, for NDA boys and all. Okay, next question. Which one among the following properties of a proton may change while it moves freely in a magnetic field? Which one among the following properties of a proton may change while it moves freely in a magnetic field? Tell me whether the speed of the proton will change, the charge will change, the mass or the velocity?
D, sir, velocity.
Velocity, sir.
what about the charge? What about the charge? What is charge of proton? Will the charge change whether it is electron, proton? The charge will have no effect. Okay. Whether it go fast, whether it goes slow, the charge will have no effect. Mass, even mass will have no effect. Speed, even speed will have no effect. So this is like, you know, you can eliminate some options. You can just easily make out that charge cannot be the option, eliminated. Mass cannot be the option, eliminated. Speed cannot be the option, eliminated. You are left with one option, that is velocity. So answer is velocity. Everyone understood?
Yes, sir.
Next, power required by a boy of mass 30 kg to run up a staircase of 40 steps in 10 seconds is how much? Okay. Now here, suppose if I want to ask you the question, they will ask you questions like, you know, what kind of work is done, whether it is a uniform work or, you know, uniform speed, that kind of question they will ask you. Now here there is a formula to calculate this power. Always just keep in mind, there is a building here. Okay, there is a building here. And suppose if I give you, a person is standing here. Okay, person, this is like case number A and this is case number B. Okay, and here in this building, there is a person. Now, in case A, look at case A, a person is standing here only. Is he doing any work?
No, sir.
He is just standing here. He is just standing here. Is he doing any work? He's not doing
anything. No,
okay, now, he is the person. In case B, you see now. Okay, he is the person. This person is climbing the staircase. Okay, this person is climbing the staircase. And now, he is here. Okay, now he is here. Now his initial point is here. Okay, this is the initial point and this is the final point. Now he is standing on the same point but on top of the building. Okay, he is standing in the same point on top of the building. Now tell me whether the bee has done work or not.
Yes, sir.
Whether the bee has done work or not. He has done it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Yes, so here, what comes into picture? The height comes into picture. Okay. So this kind of logical kind of question they will ask you. A person is standing in the same place, and a person is standing in the same place, but he is at higher elevation. Suppose a person may be under the ground or something like that. Okay. So here there is a formula, that is power is equal to work done by time taken, and what is the work done? MGH divided by T. This M stands for the mass of the boy, G stands for gravitation, H stands for height. Okay, suppose if this is the building and here there is a boy who is climbing this building from here to here. If he is climbing this building, his height has been taken into picture, gravitation, you know, mass they have given, time is 10 seconds. Okay, with that you can easily find out. Got it, boys? Understood? Okay, next. The figure given above shows the temperature T, time T plot when we start heating a piece of naphthalene. The temperature at the plateau of the curve signifies. What is that? They are asking this. What happens when, what happens here at this? Option, boiling point of naphthalene, freezing point of naphthalene, melting point of naphthalene, the temperature when naphthalene undergoes a chemical change upon heating. Find out. Anyone?
The boiling point of naphthalene.
Boiling point of naphthalene, okay. What is meant by boiling point?
Temperature.
Huh? No, here the option will be C. See, this is the option. Melting point of naphthalene. See, here, suppose if naphthalene I have kept here, okay, and I'm heating it. So what happened? The heat goes on, and here this starts melting. Okay, at this point it starts melting. At this particular time, okay, so from here, this point to this point, it is melting. Okay, and after melting from here, it will start to boil. Understood? From here, this point, it will start to boil. From this point to this point, this will be boiling. And above it, it will get into evaporation. Understood? So melting point of naphthalene. Instead of naphthalene, if I take water, okay, let us take water. Okay, to make us, I declare, imagine there is water. Tell me now, what is this point? Ice, if I take ice, water is already in liquid state. Let me take ice.
Melting point, sir.
Let us take ice. Okay, ice, what happens here? If from this point to this point, here the temperature rises, rises, rises. And it, when the ice is here, it starts melting. Correct? It starts melting. And from here, this point is called as boiling point. Ice will turn into water and then water will start boiling. Understood? Got it?
So,
yeah, doubt?
So, the melting point will be, the temperature will be constant, sir.
Melting point temperature won't be constant. If you maintain the temperature constant, it will be constant. But the temperature keeps on rising. Understood? See, what is the boiling temperature of water?
100
degrees Celsius. Okay. Now, if I'm heating the water at 50 degrees Celsius, okay, imagine if I take ice, okay, if I take ice and ice, I'm heating it at 50 degrees Celsius and I'm maintaining this 50 degrees Celsius as long as I can. Now tell me, here ice will melt, yes or no? Sharad?
Yes.
Ice will melt, right?
Yes.
Okay. So when ice is melting at 50 degrees Celsius, what will happen here? This temperature is maintained. So according to your question, here I can maintain the melting of, or the further chemical process. Understood? But now suppose if I'm heating, continuously I'm heating it, this 50 becomes 100. What will happen to this ice? Yes, it will become vapor. Correct. So at that time, I cannot say that I am a melting point will be same or through, or it will be uniform throughout the process like that. Okay. Okay. Understood. Next question. A piece of paper and a coin, both having the same mass, are dropped from the 10th floor of a building. The piece of paper would take more time to reach the ground because, I'm reading the question again, a piece of paper and a coin, both having the same mass, are dropped from the 10th floor of a building. The piece of paper would take more time to reach the ground because gravitation pull on the paper is less than the coin. Next question. Buoyant force on the piece of paper is more than that of the coin. Buoyant force on the coin is more and acts in downward direction. The piece of paper takes a longer path to reach the ground. Tell me.
B.
A, sir. The gravitational pull on the paper.
Gravitational pull, sir. Option E.
Gravitational pull. Okay. Fine, fine. No problem. Okay. Any other one? Any other option?
D, sir. C.
D.
C, sir. Buoyant force. C.
Okay, almost all have told A, B, C, D. So let us see now. Okay, option B, what they have told, buoyant force on the piece of the paper is more than that of the coin. Okay, now, buoyant force on the coin is more and acts in downward direction. And the piece of the paper takes a longer path to reach the ground. Everyone tell me whether this D option is logical options. The piece of the paper taking longer.
Yes, sir, it is logical, sir.
Yes, sir.
Due to when paper takes longer path.
See, paper may go like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. Okay, that doesn't matter.
But the same path only makes a direction.
Yeah, that doesn't matter. The path is nothing in, it is not doing anything with the paper coming on the ground. Okay, so this option is like, you know, you should eliminate. Okay, you should eliminate this option. Understood. Now, gravitation pull on the paper is less than the coin. Is less than the coin. It looks like, okay, this is the right answer. Now, just keep in mind, here what happens, gravitation is acting G, that is constant. Understood? It is not going to act on you as more or me as less. Okay, just keep these things in mind. Next, buoyant force on the piece of the paper is more than that on the coin. What is meant by buoyant force? Tell me. Can anyone tell me? What is meant by buoyant force?
The force above the paper and below the paper are the same.
Yeah.
Which makes the equation.
Okay, it acts, see, fluids, if I talk about fluids are of two types. One will be in liquid and one will be in gaseous state. Okay, gaseous states. Now what happens, suppose if there is a piece of paper here. Okay, suppose if there is a piece of paper, it is freely falling. There will be air which will be pushing it. Okay, piece of paper which will be pushing it. And imagine if this is the coin. Okay, and if the, here what happens, it is little heavy. Okay, agreed. Here it is little heavy, but now the buoyant force acting on this coin will be little less. Understood? So according to this options, option B will be the right answer. Understood? And always keep in mind buoyant force on the coin. It will never act downwards. It will always act upwards. Understood?
Sir, what is the buoyant force, sir?
Okay. See. Okay. Have you taken? Do you know swimming? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Where have you swim? In swimming pool or in river or in lake? Where?
In well, sir.
Yeah, Ratan.
In well, sir.
Well, okay, very good. Then my job is easy. See, when you are swimming in well, okay, when you are going down inside the well, suppose if this is the well, okay, and if you are going down inside the well, what pressure you feel? Do you feel that water is trying to push you upward?
Yes, sir.
Have you ever feel that it is very, you know, you more you would like to go inside, more someone is pushing upward. You know, it is difficult to go inside. So that the pushing upward, okay, suppose if this is water and this is stone, or okay, just a minute. Suppose if this is water and this is you, okay, this is you swimming inside the water. What happens here? The water, it will try to push you up. Okay, the water will try to push you up. This liquid, okay, it will act like this. It will try to push you up. This is called as buoyancy. Okay, law of buoyancy. Understood? Archimedes principle, buoyancy principle. All these questions they will ask you. Next, very interesting question. Yeah.
Sir, if the question didn't consider about the mass alone, will that option A will be considered, sir?
If it is the mass alone.
Yes, sir. Not considering the mass, like same mass.
Yeah, yeah. Then it will be correct. Then it will be gravitation pull. Understood? Actually, I like.
Sir,
yeah, tell me, Ratan.
The buoyant force means upward force, na? Upward force.
Yeah, upward force. Yeah, it is. It will not act downward. It will try to push you up. Understood? I'll clear these things, don't worry. Okay, we'll see how the questions are asked. Maybe the same question they may ask in exam this time also. Okay, don't worry. Now, very interesting question. During sunrise and sunset, sun appears reddish orange because I've explained this in evening classes. Raghavan, Naveen, tell me the answer. Tarun, tell me the answer. During sunrise and sunset, sun appears reddish orange because during that time, sun emits only reddish orange light. Option B, all other colors are absorbed by the atmosphere. Reddish orange light is least scattered by the atmosphere. All other color apart from reddish orange are reflected back in the atmosphere. Okay, so here what happens? Imagine if this is low. Okay, and here if this is sun. Okay, suppose if this is sun. So what happens if the sunlight is coming inside? Okay, suppose if during evening time, the sun will be down. Understood? The sun is going to set. Imagine the sun is going to set here. It is going to go down the horizon. So the sunlight here, it will be traveling a long path. It will travel a long path, and when it comes into the earth atmosphere, it will bend. Okay, from lighter medium to denser medium, when the light is coming, it will bend towards normal, and it will try. We feel like the sun is still above the ground. Okay, all these things are there in the light chapter. Okay, light chapter is very, very important. Now, if you see the option A, during that time, sun emits only reddish orange light. This is wrong. All other colors are absorbed by the atmosphere. Okay, reddish orange light is least scattered by the atmosphere. Option C, see how the questions are. Reddish orange light is least scattered because red light can travel a long distance. Okay, red can travel a long distance because of the wavelength, frequency, all those things you have to know, the basic things. Understood? Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. Very easy. Next question. Ohm's law can also be taken as a statement for Ohm's law. Ohm's law can also be taken as a statement for. Can you see the ninth question, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Conservation of energy, conservation of electric charge, conservation of angular momentum, non-conservation of momentum of the flowing charges. What is the answer?
Conservation of electric charge, sir.
Conservation of electric charges, sir.
Conservation of electric charges, sir.
No. This is option A, conservation of energy. Okay, what is law of conservation of energy?
Energy can neither be created nor destroyed.
Yes, neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be transferred from one
form into another state.
Yeah. Okay. This is till now we have seen so many questions. Is there any numerical problem except that kind of questions where I told you about that focus and electricity? Okay, only that two chapter you will have some problematic questions. Now see this next question. Motion of a particle can be described in x direction by x is equal to s sine omega t and y direction is by y b cos omega t. The particle is moving on a circular path of radius a, a circular path of radius b, an elliptical path, a straight line. Tell me. Find out the answer.
Option B, sir.
Option B, circular path of radius B. Okay. Then, Raghavan.
Sir, D.
Elliptical path is the right answer. Option C. Okay. This is like NDA level question. Those who are studying science. Okay. Those who have studied physics. Okay. You might be knowing how to calculate this. Okay. Now,
sir.
Yeah.
Sir, we can calculate like if sine is zero means sine zero is zero. Sine zero is one and cos zero is zero. Like that we are.
Okay, that is okay. But how do you assume it at sine? It is sine zero.
But 90 degrees is angle. 0, 90, 180, 360.
No. The question is like okay, so you are assuming it at sine 90 degrees, correct?
Yes, sir.
So sine 90 degree means what? What will happen then?
Zero.
Zero,
sir. Cos.
Okay, sine 90 is zero. Sine 90 is one, and cos 90 is zero. Okay, so ultimately, what will be the answer if you are dividing sine by cos? Then.
Tan.
See, here the option is the elliptical path. Okay, and how this elliptical path comes, it is all your basics. You have to go and check your basics. How, you have to find out, there is a formula. Okay, I can just write down the formula, take down. Those who know, x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. It satisfies this question, this value. Okay, it satisfies this value. You can find out the answer. Understood?
Okay, sir. Okay.
Next, a bullet of mass 10 gram is fired in the horizontal direction with the velocity 150 meter per second from a pistol of mass 1 kg. Recoil velocity of the pistol is. How to find the recoil velocity? How to find the recoil velocity? Yeah, Raghavan. Raghavan, are you there?
Yes, sir.
How to find it? 20 gram of bullet is there. Okay, and horizontal direction I have fired 150 meter per second. So how much back it will go? Okay, how much back it will go? Find out. Just multiply. Multiply simply 150 into 2.
3000.
3000. Now, if you see here, this is in grams, right? This is in meter per second. Kilometer per second. It is not kilometer per second. Answer will be
3 meter per second.
Okay, 3 meter per second. Understood. They have given 20 gram. Yeah. See, mass from a pistol of mass of 1 kg. Here they have given what? Kg. So if I want to find this into kg, this will be 20 by 1000. Correct? So now 2 by 100 into 150. 0, 0 cancel. So how much is the answer now? 30 by 10. 0, 0 cancel. So can I say
3 per second?
Can I say 3 meter per second?
Yes, sir. Sir, what is the recoil velocity, sir?
What is it?
Means of recoil velocity, sir.
Okay, see, when I fire a gun, will it come back?
Yes, sir.
You know, you keep a gun on a shoulder, correct? Why do you keep gun on your shoulder?
Push out.
When you fire, you light, you little go back, right? Your body little bit has a jerk, right?
Yes, sir.
That is the question here. Why it happens like that? Okay.
Okay.
Next. Suppose if we have an iron nail and an iron ball of same mass, when submerged in water, the iron ball may float, but the nail may always sink. This is because of, tell me now, buoyant force on the ball is larger than the nail due to their shapes. Viscous force is on the ball is higher. Viscous force on the nail is higher. Gravitational force affects the ball differently from the nail. Easy. Answer it faster.
Yes, sir. Buoyant force on the ball is larger than that of nail due to their shapes.
Very good. Viscous force does not play any role here. Okay, so both the viscous force I can eliminate. Yes or no? Gravitational force, I told you in the previous slide that gravitational force is same all over. Okay, this also can be eliminated. Buoyant force, it acts always upward. Suppose if this is the ball, the buoyant force here acts large, whereas the nail, it acts less. Okay, due to the surface area. Here the phenomenon of surface area comes into picture. Understood? Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you people take a break, and yes, after sir. 5 minutes we'll continue.